The question was f of x equal to 4 over x, right? Now we're finding the derivative using first principles. So the first thing, we need to determine what is f of x plus h, and that will be equal to 4 divided by x plus h. So we are replacing this x by x plus h. That's all. Okay? Then we write our formula f prime of x is equal to the limit as h tends to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. Okay? Then, from there, we substitute our expression for f of x plus h. So this will become limit as h tends to 0 of 4 over x plus h minus f of x. Now f of x is equal to 4 over x. So where there is f of x there, you replace it by 4 over x. And then you get 4 over x. This is all over h. Okay? Now it's very important for you to be aware that your main division line is this one here. Okay, that's your main division line. Your numerator, it's a difference of two fractions, so you need to simplify it. Now to do that, you need to find the LCD of this x and that x plus h. Fortunately, the LCD is going to be the product of the two. So if you want to get the LCD, means you have to multiply this numerator by x, this numerator by x plus h. So if you do that, you end up getting the limit as h tends to 0 of 4 times x, that will give you 4x. X plus h times 4 will give you minus 4 times x, then you get minus 4x. Minus 4 times this, that will give you minus 4h. This is all over the LCD, which is the product of the two denominators, that will be x times x plus h. Then we can divide this by this h here. So divided by h over 1. Alright? Okay? Any questions then? Then let's simplify that now. Now to simplify it, I'm sure you can see that this 4x and that minus 4x, they are going to cancel out. Okay? Once they cancel out, you will end up having this expression, which I'm going to write in the next page. It will be equal to the limit as h tends to 0 of minus 4h. This will be all over x times x plus h times 1 over h. Okay, I've converted the division sign, this one here, to multiplication. So I have to invert that fraction, which is h over 1. When you do that, this h here cancels with that h, so you'll be left with minus 4 over x times x plus h times 1, which will give you a limit as h tends to 0 of minus 4 over x times x plus h. Then, now I can substitute my h equal to 0, which will give me minus 4 divided by x times x plus 0, and the final answer will be negative 4 over x squared. So that will be the derivative. Okay, so it's not that challenging. Alright, so that's what you should have done yesterday. Okay, so allow me to carry on now today to move on to another aspect. Right, now it's very important for you to be aware that this whole process of using this formula, right, it's a very tedious process. Okay, there is a shortcut way of finding the derivative. Okay, to do that, we use what are called the rules of differentiation. Spokers, can you please do me a favor and be part of the maths lesson? You were eating when you came here. Now you are doing something else. Means you are disorganized. All right. So this whole process, I'm sure you can see that it's very tedious. So there's a shortcut way. Now, the process of finding a derivative in calculus, it's called differentiation. You have encountered this. This is a calculus way that you encounter if you do calculus. Differentiation. Differentiation is the process of finding the derivative. So when you find the derivative, we say that you have differentiated. Okay, the process of the act of finding a derivative is called differentiation. Is your hand up or what? What's your question? Okay, wait, you don't need to copy down the paragraph, but this part here on the rules, yes. So just give me a second.